point, I'd like to ask one question, one simple question. Are you the police of Oklahoma and Texas, every one of you, torturing Brett Finnerty in any manner whatsoever, for any reason whatsoever? Are you trying to coerce into a confession of any type? Are you withholding the truth and the evidence about these people being alive? Dale Earnhardt, my daughter, Sierra Ramsey, Skip Edmonds, Jason Chastain, many people, Don Bagdaro. Did you know that they faked their deaths to torture Brett Finnerty? Because I know a lot of people know that they did. People withholding evidence and the truth. Are you, the police of Oklahoma and Texas, torturing me with lies for any reason whatsoever? Because I believe it's called torture. You've stolen everything I've had. You keep putting me in jail. I keep telling you you're lying. You keep saying you don't know what I'm talking about, and you put me in jail again. Now, as you look at this, just remember what you've done to me. You've never done to anybody else that I know of in the entire world. I believe this is what you would call cruel and very unusual punishment. And it's called torture because you will not tell the truth. You're withholding evidence. You're withholding the truth. And all that you have done is put me in jail, stalk me, try to arrest me again and again and again, and set me up to be arrested when I have done nothing but try to make you tell the truth. Now, I got a few questions to ask, and I'm hoping somebody wants to start telling the truth so I can go live my life and watch you guys rot in a jail cell for trying to murder Brett Finnerty. Is this person alive? Because I know he is. You won't tell the truth. You lied in my face. It's a joke. It's not a joke. You've ruined my entire life. I hate you. Is this person alive? I know she is. I know you're going to lie to my face. You've been lying the whole time. She's alive. You tortured me with this. This is how you tried to kill me. This right here. Is this person alive? I know he is. I know you're going to lie to my face. You're just trying to bring it up and say, look, it's over. Stop. Stop. And then you're going to bring your cops up to hurt me again. Arrest me when nobody's paying attention. When the heat dies down, that's what you do. Wait till the heat dies down. Is this person alive? I know that he is. You guys don't want to tell the truth. I hope this person's alive. I'm pretty sure he is, because Everett Briggs said, look, was Michael Jackson a celebrity thing, you know, celebrity event here when he's supposed to die just yesterday? And Everett Briggs just happened to say, hey, Brett, Michael Jackson said, this is it. You got something to say? I don't know. I guess he's going to retire. Maybe he says he's done performing. Well, I don't know. And then all of a sudden he's dead. Everett Briggs, you know something about Michael Jackson being murdered? Everett Briggs from Motorola Intel Corporation. Everett Briggs. Is this person alive? I know he's alive. You guys are trying to show me these people. Say, look, it's over. Stop. We don't want to get in trouble for what we did. No, you tried to murder me. Is this person alive? I know she is. Nobody dies from a rotator cuff. Bleeding to death from a rotator cuff. That's what they're going to try to do. A rotator cuff surgery on Han Wong too, weren't y'all? Try that. Now, this next one's going to hurt. Is this person alive? I know he is. You're going to be rotten in a prison cell. You don't think so, but you can find out you are. It's illegal to do what you've done. The problem is people are looking at you right now going, Harvey, you can't do this kind of stuff. So, but Ardmore, you're corrupt. We're doing the right thing. You're not doing the right thing. You tried to torture me. You tried to murder me. You still will not tell the truth. You let me go into your city where everybody just mocks, laughs, humiliates. This is what you call cruel and unusual punishment. This is illegal. Illegal. Why do you look like Kyle Whaley? Why does Kyle Whaley, the FBI agent who hypnotized me at Yada Network Inc., look a lot like you, Harvey Burkhart? Why? Now, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about, you know, hypnotism. First, it's real. People say, no, you can't do that stuff. Yeah, you can't. It's real. You know it's real. Now, there's supposed to be laws about using hypnotism. Number one, and this is Texas, where you guys did the hypnotism, but you guys have been hypnotizing me here for a very long time. The police know that you know how to do it, and you keep lying about it. You're a liar. You're about to go to prison for what you did because you can't get out of this one. You are caught. The problem here is in Texas, you're not supposed to hypnotize any. The only people you're allowed, you're never allowed to force someone to be hypnotized. That's one. You're not allowed to force it. Call what enforced it. Number two, you're only allowed to hypnotize the witnesses or the person that the crime happened to. Never a suspect or never the accused. Never the accused. Because they can plant stories in someone's mind and make them lie. That's what a police officer says. That's the rules they have to hypnotism. Jeanette Ramsey, you did say you adopted somebody, a 15-year-old daughter, around the year, I don't know, it was around the year 2000 time frame, 99, 2000. It was about around the time me and April moved to Plano, Texas. You said you adopted some girl who was 15 years old, and Sierra was younger, I remember that. But 2005 is when you fake Sierra Ramsey's death. You're trying to confuse everybody and lie and get away with what you do. You can't get away with it, Jeanette Ramsey. You can't. I heard that you were out there and you were tearing up the ground. That's what I'd heard. You were tearing up the ground. You and Chris, you were smiling, had little hose and everything. You were tearing up the ground to make it look like a car wreck. Just in case I went to go check to see if it was real. That's what I heard you did. I heard people went by to take pictures, but the police took their cameras away and said, you can't have that. You can't have that. Now, the problem is there's been a plot against me for a very, very long time. When I was a child, there was a plot against me. And you don't want to tell the truth, but Tina Bryant knows the truth. Beth Kimbrough knows the truth. Many people know the truth. Emmy Kate from Adil knows the truth. Michael Thompson knows the truth. Everyone knows the truth. Nobody wants to tell the truth. That's the problem. So what I'm going to show you is part of this conspiracy that you cannot cover up. It's already there. You can't hide what you've done. Now what I'm going to show you is Tom Fuller, Charles Ray, where he was. How did he end up in Lone Grove, Oklahoma? And then all of a sudden, he's Tom Fuller in Lone Grove, Oklahoma. And then all of a sudden, he's Charles Lewis Ray, he's Charles Lewis Ray at Alcatel. And he's the person who calls the U.S. Marshals on him in the FBI. He goes up and down the chain of command doing anything he can to get Brett Finnerty in trouble. Where'd you come from, Charles Ray? What are you doing in Lone Grove, Oklahoma in the year 1988 calling yourself Tom Fuller? What are you doing that for, Charles Ray? Back here. There he is. Tom Fuller, right there. Charles Lewis Ray. What are you doing in Lone Grove, Oklahoma, trying to set Brett Finnerty up in 1988? What are you doing pounding around with Ken Bondrick? What are you doing with Ken Bondrick? This alone proves that there's a conspiracy right there. That Tom Fuller, Charles Lewis Ray, being at Alcatel. He's proof alone. Now, this Charles Ray knows somebody from Kingston, Oklahoma. He was somebody I knew and my brother knew in Kingston. His name was Will or Willow, something like that. And his house is down there. It's all lit up. At least that's where he used to live. His mother had a blue station wagon. He's related to this Charles Raton Bullard guy. He said, stay away from him. He's a bad person. Yeah, he's a very bad person. He told them I had a $10,000 drum set so they'd open an investigation. But the problem is this plot has been going for a very long time. And that right there is proof of it. 1988, right? Charles Ray. Now, I bought this hot sauce yesterday. This stuff right here. I bought this yesterday at a little place in Oklahoma City. And there was a guy in there that kind of resembles what Bruce Mills would look like if he was young. Maybe he's related to Bruce Mills. Maybe he's not. All I know is I had seen him somewhere before. When I got this hot sauce, I started talking. I started telling him a few things about what happened at Alcatel and how they set me up in Alcatel. And now I told him about Dream Theater, right? First, I told him about Bruce Mills and how Bruce Mills raped Lee Trin. I told him about Bill Hopper and how I was set up for this stuff, and I didn't do it. I told him about Stone Cold Steve Austin letting Bruce Mills rape Lee Trin. And he looked like he swallowed a rock. I don't know where he started realizing the mistake you guys made, but he realized. I also told this man about 9/11, you know, being faked. And Chris Christian knows 9/11's fake. Gordon Butler knows 9/11's fake. Diane Butler knows 9/11's fake. Dream Theater, the band, knows 9/11's fake. Many people know 9/11's fake. I had people from Lawton saying, when you got to see those water towers, that's the real Twin Towers. The other ones are fake. I said, what are you talking about? And that's what people actually told me when they were in the military. This guy told me the Afghan war was real because he was there and he was all choked up. He looked like, man, he looked like he wanted to throw up. He looked like he wanted to throw up like he went to a war that shouldn't happen because they faked it because of what you guys did to me. You guys did to me. Why did we have a war in Afghanistan if you fake 9/11? Because Dream Theater knows. I mean, I can go over that album cover over and over again. The problem is Chris Christie showed me a picture of Corey Butler and Diane Butler standing in front of Twin Towers. And Corey Butler and Diane Butler were holding a sign smiling. And the sign said, September 12th, 2001. The Twin Towers were still standing behind them in New York. And they said, we finally got you, Brett, September 12th, 2001. Now, why in the world would you fake a 9/11 attack and then go and have a war to cover it up? Why would you do that? What are you covering up, Carter County? Did you not?
One by one,
yes,
each lawman turned criminal,
yes,
heard chilling details of the crimes against them,
yes,
and stoically admitted their guilt in front of a judge.
Yes.